By the way, you can get more detail on this matter in the analytic note of the Foundation of Conceptual Technologies, the law of the Central Bank of the Russian Federation and the sovereignty of Russia, which is part of the book on the world of crooked mirrors. Let's go to the next question from Viktor. Valery Viktorovich, don't you think that technological progress was, if not stopped, then strongly slowed down approximately in the 70s of the 20th century? For it is obviously lagging behind the hopes of the 1950s and 1960s in many spheres. Here is an example of progress slowing. The speed of our mobility is no longer rising. A steady, centuries-lasting history of appearing of faster kinds of transport, which began with sailboats in the 16th century, continued with the development of railways in the 19th century, and the advent of cars and aviation in the 20th century, was reversed in 2003, when the Concorde, the last ultrasonic jet, was written off. Considering such regression and stagnation, those who are still dreaming about spaceships and vacations on the moon seem to be aliens themselves. So will the law of time work?
The law of time works strictly. And the slowing down of science and technology development is a guided process. There is a commercial that is more than 3 or 4 hours long, maybe even longer. I mean the movie, which was produced as an advertisement, Back to the Future, in three parts. There was a big bluff story concerning the producing of a flying car. The car was created especially for this case, and was shot in the film. It was a big bluff. Everyone can look for it on the net. But what is the point? What is it all about? The action in this film takes place in 1985. But in the imaginary future, in 2015, flying cars are already a reality. A flying car was not considered a fantasy in 1985. It was not because they were 30 years ahead, but because the development of science was so high that it was supposed to happen. However, in 1985, there were signs of slowing down already, because things that people dreamt about in the 1960s, things that seems possible in the 1960s, all those visions were not turned into reality for some reason. And those dreams were not achieved because development of creativity in the USSR suddenly began fading. What engines does NASA use now? The engines that were created for the flight to the moon. Our engines that were created for the lunar program are able to deliver a rocket to the moon, but Americans who allegedly were on the moon can't even develop an engine more or less suitable for launching their own spaceships. The bluff of Elon Musk doesn't hold water. Only people who don't want to figure anything out can believe this bluff. They are so strongly charmed by the USA that their critical thinking completely turns off. They don't even try to apply knowledge they have acquired, for example, in Soviet times. What is the point here? The point is that knowledge is given to us according to our morality. This is important to remember. Let's look back deeper into the past. What do we see? We see that throughout centuries, supranational government has always tried to slow down technical progress as much as possible. Remember the Inquisition, and to stop the development of society. In the 19th century, there appeared some movements in Great Britain that we are determining not only the future political structure of the world regarding countries' status. Firstly, they held a natural experiment, the Boer War. And then, based on this experiment, they held World War, carried out in two stages, World War I and World War II. They also conducted more prolonged and fundamental research. There was a society in art, the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood, who were looking for the optimal point to stop technological development of the society on a certain stage and leave the social structure somewhere at the feudal level. The same task is now being carried out by ISIS and other fundamentalist movements, which are allegedly Islamic. It is an insult to Islam to call these movements Islamic, but nevertheless, they assign such names to themselves. So the essence is as follows. First, the global predictor supposed that considering the way of life they lead, the planet would be able to support 1 golden billion, served by another billion of attendant people, and 1 more billion of auxiliary population. The latest are supposed to be herds of people wandering on territories which will be polluted and made uninhabitable by the golden billion. They will be spending their lives recultivating these lands. But then the plans changed. As technologies developed, it became clear that it was enough to keep the population under 500 million, with the remaining people eliminated. There are approximately 8 billion people on the planet today, so the global predictor have to do something with them. What does the world they suggest to live in look like? They envisage various variants of this world, and Hollywood is in different ways exploring scenarios of future life on Earth. For example, the comedy The Big Bang Theory, it tells us about many conceptual things regarding how life might be arranged, what science in the American society is, and how science affects social sphere. Another example is the movie Humans, which is on cable channels. Biorobots are domestic helpers there. And outwardly, there is almost no difference between them and people, but biorobots are functioning under program control. That is the global predictor, are looking for different ways of preserving the planet for themselves, beloved, so that they can use its resources as long as possible. Because if everybody lives a life based on the philosophy of Western individualism, if everybody has American level of consumption, full devastation of the Earth is inevitable. A demonstration project for the American way of life was launched for 5%, so that everybody would like to live like them. Demonstration of prosperity within this flagship project was crucial to the destruction of the USSR. And now, look, this project in the US is being shut down. People start having serious problems because they no longer consume as much as before, and the US is doomed to disappear into nothingness following the USSR. Once again, about the thesis that knowledge is given to us according to our morality. When was humanity given new technological knowledge? In times when a new social order became more humane than the previous one, more relevant to the development of human potential. Why did Rome defeat Carthage? A vivid explanation of this question was suggested in the Soviet cartoon Коля, Оля and Archimedes. A Roman warlord says to the soldiers ready to kill their enemy Archimedes, Don't you dare lift a finger to harm this dignified man. And what was the generals of Carthage attitude to Archimedes? Who is he? I'm a general. And who is he? A mere technician and mathematician. They treated knowledge with disregard. They didn't appreciate it. Conceptual things are expressed in this cartoon. Everything you want to know about the difference between Carthage and Rome is expressed in this cartoon. Distinction in attitude to knowledge. That is why Rome, that valued knowledge, and where a Jewish slave, Josephus Flavius, captured in Judea, became a member of the emperor's family, was a more humane system than the Carthaginian one. That is why humanity moved forward. That is why Rome had bigger technical achievements. The highest point of human development was the USSR, where any social class member could enter the governance. A peasant, a worker, anyone. The USSR was a system that maximally facilitated the development of human genetic potential. Accordingly, the development of human genetic potential gave rise to creativity, which pushed forward the state and the whole world forward. Creativity. Here is an interesting observation. In the 1990s, the USSR was completely destroyed as a result of its governing officials' betrayal. All technologies and innovations were given to the United States, but the United States was not able to master the technologies and use them in practice. Why? Because it is not enough to build some plant. It is not enough to launch some production process. The quality of the society has to correspond with the level of the technical task. The quality of our society corresponds with the task of space exploration, but the quality of the American society does not. They are not able to master and support processes at such technological level because the techniques they use to govern the society are based on suppressing of human genetic potential. And no matter how hard they try to attract specialists from all over the world, their managers, who are brought up in elite schools, do not possess polytechnic comprehensive expertise. And most importantly, they set society governance goals that are based on parasitic degradation and suppression of creativity. Naturally, the US has no prospects, as well as the Western world as a whole. Of course, there is future. It is necessary to at least start restoring Stalin's education system and Stalin's human resource policy, which gives an opportunity to everyone to find his place in society according to his genetic potential. If you have a manager talent, welcome to the management or governance sphere. If you are good at engineering, here's your job in the industry. If you are a creative person, take up painting, literature, any branch of art. And all these professions have to be respected in a united society, depend on each other, influence each other, just as it was in the Soviet society. That is why the USSR could propel the whole world, and all Western welfare programs became possible only because the USSR existed. No Soviet Union, no programs. They are being wound down. The USSR pulled the whole world towards humanity. The West makes people degrade. In fact, the East doesn't differ much. So the whole of humanity looks at Russia with hope. Russia, give us a new push of development. Help us to get out of this. And the West, I repeat, Do you know what a monkey with a hand grenade means? There are videos of UN soldiers giving an assault rifle to a monkey. And where did they run from that monkey after that? It amused the monkey that everyone was hiding from it, and something was knocking in his arms. The animal doesn't understand anything. Who deserves to be given knowledge? The USSR met the requirements of the task to develop human genetic potential of each citizen. Consequently, knowledge was given to it. The West doesn't meet the requirements and is, therefore, deprived of knowledge from above. Knowledge is given to us according to our morality. If people don't work to grow themselves, they will not gain knowledge. Degradation follows and corresponds with the implementation by the global predictor of a governance task to make animals a herd of the Earth population. Somebody yields to it with pleasure, but generally people resist it.